Show me your f***ing hands.
Police emergency.
Bring it down.
Stop, stop.
Blue lights, what do they mean? Relax, brother.
Not what normal 22-year-olds see.
Get out of here, boy.
That's not very nice.
Wasn't expecting that.
I don't know if he's armed or anything.
Friday night. I won't be anywhere else. Hey! Go, boy!
Charlotte, November Echo for golf. Late shift, am I?
Control to November Lima 4-3, Heather.
Saturday night.
Let's
make it a good one.
Let's go.
My favourite car, hands down, is this car. It's just it's a Gucci-looking vehicle, isn't it?
Yeah.
Proper Gucci. Black.
I've cleared a flat here.
Yeah.
We've got a match on. Do you think we could just sit here and watch the match?
Yeah, go on.
There, look, on the right.
Callum and me, we love crewing up together. Being double crewed and going out together is our idea of a good laugh. It's good fun to be with your best mate. On a Friday, Saturday night, going out in a car, chasing down the criminals.
Control out to Ormobars, grade one, sorted the mail in the centre of that.
Yeah, that's monitored. We're about a minute away. So we've just had a report that a male's been knocked unconscious at one of the bars down here outside.
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, I've got something. 1-0, that's fine, sir.
I'm
right, you know.
Put your hands out to the side for me.
Mate, you're under arrest, suspicion of ABH at the minute, OK?
I got jumped by ABH. I was trapped down, and then two lads come up, bang, bang, bang. I'm not going
to
get on.
I know. Just listen to me.
Intoxicated people are difficult to manage. They're very, very unpredictable, and you just never know when they're going to switch to screaming their head off and throwing punches. So you definitely need eyes in the back of your head.
Just stop shouting for us. Stop shouting.
I just think I'm going
to. When I'm not at work, I am a DJ. You're talking to people that are drunk. You're dealing with people that are drunk. You've got someone requesting Mamma Mia constantly.
Bring your voice down.
That, coupled with your training, always giving me the experience to be able to deal with the majority of the people that we do deal with.
Talk to me nice for that, I'll get the f***ing car.
Lower your voice and get in that car, right? Get in the car.
What
and lower
are
your
you
voice.
Gonna do?
Put that van there, man.
Push me, boy.
Roll over if you can.
Push me, boy.
Calm down.
Calm down. So, male's been arrested at the moment for assault, and obviously he's gone from here to through the roof, so very agitated. So he's getting him under control, getting in the van, and we'll be taking him to custody.
Whilst we're waiting, some other bloke turns up, starts kicking off.
Hey, listen, yeah? These boys here to the left.
Bro, boy!
Panic, split-second reaction, just ran at him and grabbed him as quick as I could. And at that point, he's turned around and tried to headbutt me. He's going to try and kick me, he's going to try and punch me. But he was clearly going to assault officers, so we had to get him under control.
Calm down.
As much as I tend to go for the good cop approach, had to get the tiger out of the bag and get him on the floor as quick as I could. He needed to contain him.
Calm down.
The tiger out the bag is having to unleash your aggression and be the bad cop. Sometimes if you've had a real good scrap and where you've had to really wrestle with someone, you sometimes get the sick feeling in your stomach afterwards where your adrenaline spiked. You can't hear your radio, your ears switch off. Sometimes a weird little tummy ache I've got once or twice.
That was carnage. He was absolutely vile, really aggressive. But it's always a difficult one, because you can either keep your distance or you can get hands-on and get close. But, of course, when you're up close, you've got a lot more chance of getting hurt. So, yeah, I was in fear that he was going to headbutt me. Yeah, in that moment, I thought I was going to get a big nook to the nose. All right, Meg, jump out.
in this job. There'll be days when you're going to be run ragged, and then there'll be other days when you're not.
You can have nights like this where it can be quiet, but yeah, there's just a generally accepted rule that you don't say the Q word. A bit of superstition, really.
I don't believe in that nonsense. I'll happily stay quiet every day, all day. Have you got your license on you, brother? Do you know why you've been stopped today at all? Yeah. You need to sort your headlights out, okay?
My journey as a sergeant has literally just begun. It's a new chapter for me, it's a new beginning.
Next time you will probably end up getting a ticket, yeah?
I've personally went for it because there were certain jobs I was going to, different sergeants were coming to it as well, and I'll be thinking, I could do that. I think I would have done a lot more better than that without being too arrogant, do you know what I mean?
Make sure his license is valid then and he's not wanted.
As a sergeant for the team, I could take someone out, show the ropes, teach them how it's done, essentially build them up to be a great police officer.
So we're just looking for high-performance type of vehicles or your small vehicles that are quite nippy and any cars that are parked not appropriately.
When you've got a young shift, the thing sometimes, oh, the controller is not sending me to any jobs, therefore, I'm just gonna chill. No, go out there, develop your policing skill. Because when you generate your own work, you take much more greater pride in it because you're like, yeah, I went out there, but I got him.
Do you want to run this car through?
Yep, it's Mercedes, isn't it?
Yeah. Is he trying to do a U-turn to come back out?
I think so, yeah.
That car just didn't feel right, the way it turned. You know, the body language of that vehicle. This guy is up to no good.
Turn your engine off. Turn your engine off for me.
Hello.
How are you? Is this your car, sir?
Yeah.
Yeah? You live here?
No.
Where do you live?
Hamilton.
Hamilton?
Yeah.
I know Hamilton very well. I'm just trying to figure out why you've come all the way to a residential area.
Sarge, he's got gloves on.
Okay, right. I will hold your car key. At this moment in time, you're detained for a stop and search, okay? Step out. Don't put your hands in your pockets, yeah? Have you got anything sharp on you?
No.
No? Okay. Hands out. Why are you breathing very heavily?
Sorry?
You seem very nervous.
No.
No? Okay. Just face the car. What language do you speak?
Polish.
Polish. Okay. Yeah.
Most people are nervous, let's be honest. My mum is the most nervous person. She's in a cop car, she gets nervous for no reason. But it's being able to differentiate the person who's just naturally nervous because there's a cop car behind them to the other person who's nervous because they got something to hide.
We're having a lot of burglaries around here. You're not from this area, and I'm not happy with the rationale as to why you're here.
What are these gloves for? What are these gloves for?
Nothing.
Okay.
What are you two lads in the early hours in the morning doing here? Passengers wearing gloves in a car, and I call it burglar's glove, really, because he ain't doing no gardening or DIY.
Sarge?
Yeah?
Got potential going equipped as well. Looks like it's kitted up, ready for burglary.
What we got?
Okay. Gloves there.
Yeah.
This bag, a torch on either side as well. Little bat that was in there as well. Got a knife as well. Locking blade, about 4.5 inches, maybe. Okay.
Yours?
Yeah, my right.
At this moment in time, you're under arrest on possession of a bladed article. Sit on the floor for me.
You can use that knife?
He's not allowed to have it in a public place. It's illegal.
There's something off here, but not enough for us to actually arrest him for going equipped. But in there was a lock knife for which he was arrested.
With a sandwich.
Do you use it for sandwich? We'll sort it at the station.
Right.
Yeah.
No criminal, no.
Yeah.
No banditos.
When you find a knife, you feel happy, of course, because we all know the impact that knife crime has. When I put the handcuffs on you, yeah? I don't feel sorry for you because you've got a knife, and ignorance is no excuse. As a result of that stop check, we've got one less knife on the street now.
That was a good little job, well done, mate. And all just from, you know, seeing a car and just going with your gut instincts, really.
Spidey senses were tingling, weren't they?
All right, we're on. He's on. Wait.
Hello.
I don't know about you, Tommy, but there's a lot of pressure on young officers. They give you so much to do and you just have to do it. And
I don't know, you've got to look after yourself in this job and look after your own health and get that downtime where you just forget about work. Because there's no point in getting to 55, is there, and then
conking out
because you're too ill, because you've ruined yourself.
Sound advice.
I've been with the force 6 months.
You do that kind of thing where you put it on Facebook and, I've got this new job, I'm a cop now. To begin with, obviously everyone's like, really, what, the police? It's weird, like, coming out as a cop, because it's like, you don't want people to perceive you as different. You feel like they're not going to tell you as much anymore, but it doesn't actually affect anything. It's just, you still are who you are, aren't you, really?
November Whiskey 41. Could you have a look at incident 552 for us?
Yeah, we can assist with that. We'll make our way. A male's called us saying that he's been talking to a female through a dating website. She's sold him some images. She's then told him she's under 18 and she wants money off him or she's going to call the police onto him.
See what he's got to say.
See what he's got to say about it, I guess.
My kind of style of policing is to be quite empathetic towards others. It's to talk to people. I think a lot of my colleagues from my station would know I'm definitely a talker.
I find it easier to talk someone down than wrestle them down, if you know what I mean.
What's actually happened?
Okay, so I was on a dating site and I was talking to an individual. She said that she was selling content,
okay,
which is a common thing on dating apps.
Yeah.
The images she sent to me are a bit revealing as a schoolgirl.
Let's have a look, pal. Let's have a little look. Do you want to have us?
Yeah, yeah, no problem. She said to me that the images were of her as an underage. She threatened to blackmail me and she said that she's done this to many other blokes. And she said that guys have sent £1,000.
Yeah, that's what they do. They got your grip then, haven't they? Yeah.
Exactly.
She's clearly young, but she's not a child.
Yeah.
What made you pay £10 for photos?
Yeah, I've come out of a 4-year relationship. I'd be rude, I'm not talking too well. I have been quite depressed and I wasn't eating, I wasn't sleeping. I'm just kind of...
You're not behaving like your normal self then?
Not really.
I felt quite sorry for him. I can see how it can happen. If you're feeling that low in a place like that, you can, you're capable of anything in that situation. It's not their fault, it's just they've been manipulated to do that.
With your mental health stuff, it can spiral and get on top of you very, very quickly. You can't just bury your head. Are you medicated for anything?
No, I don't really believe in my stepdad. He was on a lot of antidepressants and stuff like that, and he was an alcoholic and he wasn't particularly the best person to be around.
Obviously, from that, that's why you've kind of a bit of dip in your depression and things like that, because of...
Kind of.
Yeah.
He was quite physical when he had a drink. I've actually got a scar on my eyelid. I used to wear glasses, and he punched me in the face when I came back from school late once. It was physical and mental abuse for a long time. I never really got over it.
Everyone has low days, obviously. I've had a few. My dad was arrested when I was young. The police get down the door, actually. So they arrested him, and I was taken into care.
The police took me into care when I was 7. I didn't know the ins and outs. At that point, I just saw them as taking me away from my family. So in a sense, they're kind of the villains in that story. But when I was 14, I kind of saw actually what I was going through was, you know, quite bad, and that the police had actually saved me from that situation.
From my experience, I know that talking about things like that does help.
Yeah.
Even if it's like us or anyone, can't bury your hand in the sand and just kind of want it to go away. It won't. It's best to get some help.
Because I've been through something similar, I kind of know what it feels like. So I think it's quite useful to have that experience, although terrible experience to go through. It's helped me now, you know, in terms of being able to communicate with someone who's been through something similar.
In relation to what we've got here, I'm happy on there that she's not a child.
It's a scam.
Yeah.
They're just trying to blackmail you for money. We'll send you a link, and then from that you can send us the images so we actually have them on record. If it does come up again,
yeah,
or if she comes back to you saying, oh, you want all this kind of money and stuff, we have it on our record then, don't we? But yeah, don't worry about today, it'll be fine. It was nice meeting you, mate. Look after yourself, yeah?
Thank you.
No worries.
When you finish your shift, you still think about that person sometimes. You still worry about them in terms of, I hope they're okay. I will sometimes call my foster mum because she kind of knows me better than anyone. She's dealt with all this with me from when I was younger. And just say, I need some advice on just dealing with this, and it does help to unload it.
Life's a learning curve. You learn by your mistakes, don't you? And he won't do that again now.
Me being younger, I'm a bit not desensitised to it as much as you have, yeah.
I haven't got a heart, mate.
You haven't got a heart, is that what it is?
My heart's gone. Yeah. Maybe you're more caring, Jason. Maybe that's what it is.
Maybe that's what it is.
Maybe that's what it is.
That's the sound of the police. Whoop, whoop. That's the sound of the beast.
This isn't the worst that I've got, but I don't think you want to hear it, if I'm honest. That's the sound of the police. Stand clear.
Done, man, attack. You can't stand where I stand. You can't walk where I'm thinking, what on earth?
What are these kids in police cars? Well, they probably report on 999. I think kids have stolen a police car. And on Jolly. That's the sound of the police.
That's the sound of the police. 1993, thank you.
Unicorn silence. Wait, that's nice. Just leave no space for me.
Yeah. Brute force.
My childhood was very, very good. Very protected by my family. Wrapped in cotton wool, I would say.
I felt that in my stomach.
What, that?
Yeah. It was never remotely going to prepare me for what I've experienced on the job.
Echo 4 Echo.
Yes, Echo.
Female that was at the address, she had a few issues with two males who were asking for £60.
Not to show, yes,
thank you. Talk to 813, I'm asking if you could just shout on those, please. Hello? Yeah. Have you called us? Are we allowed to come in? So what's happened then?
Today, they're coming demanding money off me. If I don't give it in, I will get my windows put in. I just said, get out. Get out. You know what? As soon as I get paid, they're on me like vultures. And if I don't give them money, I get threatened. Yeah. I've had my gates kicked in. Mm. I've had my door kicked in.
Yeah.
I've been bullied, harassed, but no one's listening.
It's unacceptable for someone to do this to you. With my policing style, I think it is very much having that conversation with people and be able to have that understanding with them. Yeah. Putting people first. We're not in a rush or anything. This person needs us to listen to them.
I'm 6 years of age.
Yeah.
I'm battling cancer.
Mm.
I should have to put up with this. They put one window through.
Yeah.
I've had threats now of all my windows coming through.
Did you report that to the police?
Yes.
Yeah.
The community police officers.
Oh, neighbourhood police officers, they came in.
Came. He says, I'm going to look into it.
OK, I'm going to just find out really quickly what the plan is and let you know, is that OK? There's an officer, I think, that's actually designated. Whoever came earlier knows exactly what she's told us now, so there's nothing we can do there. Before I was police officer, I'd say I was quite an emotional person, but I think now, a year in, as much as you want to just be very, very empathetic to this person because, you know, they're going through a lot and they seem very distressed, there is that kind of line where you have to draw where it's not a personal kind of conversation, it's between a police officer and an individual. Are you getting help from anyone? Are you in touch with anyone from other services or anything? Would you be open to that?
You've got to deal with it yourself.
But the thing is, there are agencies that can help you in terms of what you're
doing. I know
with.
That new police officers are lovely. You've always treated me with respect.
Sometimes it's difficult to kind of police people that are much older because I'm like, I can't relate to you. I'm 22. I have none of that going on in my own life. But I think because they see you in uniform, they do take your advice on board. If any of them come again, just get on the 9 straight away. Because we'll be here, and the thing is, we'll be able to do something about it if they're still here. And you feel
I know,
like...
I know, I appreciate that, darling. Yeah. Okay. I really do.
Cool.
Can I give you a hug?
Yeah, you can do. Bless you. Honestly, if you need anything, just give us a call, OK? This was super weird for me, because no one's ever said that to me on a job before, and no one's ever said, oh, yeah, I want to give you a hug.
Yeah.
It's quite nice, because it was just the fact that someone appreciated us being there for them.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
No,
see you later.
See you later.
Take care.
At that point, you know, she seemed really calm, you know, no more tears or anything. It's a good feeling because it makes you walk away and you're like, you know what, I did something good. And I got a hug out of it. Can we eat now? I need to go get food. I'm hungry.
Where are we getting food?
Tea white nun for Sergeant Gale. Go for the elf mug.
cup of tea, Gaffer.
Thank you very much. So, how do you feel about having to move to a different department now?
I'm a bit gutted, to be honest with you. I love everyone here, I love the team. I can't think of anything that would be better than doing response.
After 2 years on response, unfortunately, I'm being moved to a different department, to a different station. Where there's an operational need, forced to have the power to place us somewhere else. It's a CID, shirt and tie detective role, as opposed to response, blue lights, excitement sort of role. And I am gutted.
I mean, for what it's worth from our side, it'll be a shame to lose you off the team. You've been constantly enthusiastic, you've been keen, even at the most stupid hour of the morning with the most long-winded job, you've carried on plucking away with it, which I can't ask for any more than that.
It is going to be a big growth opportunity for me. I think I'm just loving response so much that I can't see myself doing anything else.
No, and it is a shame to move from something when you're happy with it, but you'll gain different skills from it and it will help you make you a more rounded police officer. Keep up with how you've been towards it here and you'll be fine.
Thank you very much, Sarge.
When's your last day? Is it this week?
Well, yeah.
Sad to be missed.
What do you reckon you're going to do without me?
Cry, mate, probably. Yeah.
You're going to be lost, aren't you?
It will be different.
Yeah. Glory boy duo.
Yeah.
It's heartbreaking because I'm going to lose all my colleagues and it is tearing apart the family. It genuinely feels like a breakup.
I will miss our nighttime economy shifts, though.
I'll still be out having fun on Saturday night. You're going to be sat behind a desk.
My ideal dream role was to be a response officer. I can't be as happy as I was when I was doing that role. And it just seems like I've lost my job, basically.
Are you alright?
What's the cake one for?
Was this the tyres?
Yeah.
Okay.
One for each tyre.
Oh, one
for each. A cake fine is where if someone does something wrong, then they bring in some cakes. In my instance, it was clipping the curb and deflating the tyres. We'll leave it at that.
Oh, God.
So I wear the G shift, the best of the best. My role as a sergeant with is to ensure that they enjoy the work that they do, they're happy. Work as one team, work as one family, innit?
Right, we're gonna go do some work. See you later.
Cool.
Right, have fun.
See you later.
The sort of sergeant I am, I'll always get stuck in. So if you mean nicking someone, I'll nick someone. I'll never ask my team to do something that I will never do. And your team will naturally respect you for that.
Control 2, Alpha 43.
Go ahead.
You're going to the Grade 1 in Harborough?
Yeah, I'll take a look now.
The male was arrested for causing serious injuries to his partner. He was released less than 12 hours ago, and we got a call saying he's back at the address with her.
Hello. Hello, hi, it's the police. Can you let me in, please?
I go in. The door's open.
Anyone home? It's the police. Yo. Anyone in? Police officer with a taser. Show yourself.
You just pushed the window open and jumped out of it.
The window's wide open, so I had a look down and there it is, just landed on the floor.
Sergeant Ahmed, he's just chucked himself out of the window. Got another crew nearby.
Roger, we're 5 minutes out.
I quickly ran out, but he's disappeared.
Roger.
She's a victim of high-risk domestic abuse, so he knows he's not meant to be here. And it's the reason why he jumped out of the window and legged it. He's hiding somewhere here. He can't have gone far. Sergeant Ahmed. Are there any drone mobiles available at all today?
There's a large field behind the address. I was hoping if they could just fly the drone, see if he's hiding in the fields.
He's fallen approximately 5 metres and he couldn't have gone too far. So, essentially getting the team all down there so we can conduct a search of the whole area in order to try and locate him.
So, the back window over there, he jumped out. He was on the floor, like he hurt his leg. I'm thinking there's a fair bet he's probably run around the back.
Yeah.
All right?
Yeah. Where do you want us, Sarge?
So, I'm just thinking, if one of you guys could go around all the way to the back of the field with the panda, and the other one to come round here. We've got the drone coming and the dog coming, and they're coming purely for that field because of how big it is.
Okay.
Happy day. Yes.
I'll see you guys in a minute.
See ya.
If you've got a good relationship with your team and your team respect you, then I think that goes a long way. If you're singing off the same sheet and there's cohesion within your team as well, your team will be willing to give you 110%.
November Alpha 41.
Dad. The male's under arrest.
Located around the back of the
block
flat.
Sergeant Ahmed, did I get him?
Yes, around the back of the block flat, Sarge.
He says he requires medical attention. He's hurt his back and his legs.
Attention. What's wrong with your back?
My back's sore.
Let's call him an ambulance.
Oh, please, can I go back in my house? I'm freezing. Please, can I go back into my house?
No, we're not going to allow you to do that.
Why is that? Why can't I go back into my house?
Being arrested, okay.
What have I been arrested for?
Witness intimidation.
Well, we've got a full blanket for you here. It's going to keep you warm, all right? Come on then, mate. There we go, nice and warm.
Hello, hi, ambulance, please.
It's Sergeant Adam Armour calling from Leicestershire Police.
Is there any serious bleeding?
Negative.
Is he completely alert?
Yep.
No. Oh, back killing.
Yeah, he is.
And he's got a back injury?
Yeah.
Please, can we go back to my house?
Is he having any difficulty breathing?
Yeah.
He's saying, yeah, he's got breathing problems, but he's got enough to shout at us.
Can I lie down?
Do you want my jacket? I'll put it under your head.
Thank you.
That's as much as I can do for
a minute.
Myself and Matt were doing an area search. We found the male hiding in some bushes. I actually arrested this chap probably about a year and a half ago, my first ever arrest. So, being reunited.
What I'll do is, I'll head back to Wixton. I'll ask them to come here to relieve you guys. And then he will be dealt with in the morning.
He'll basically be transported to hospital, and then once discharged, he'll come back into our care, and we'll deal with the offences.
This situation was 100% a team effort. They all came down, which resulted in one male getting nicked and ultimately safeguarding the victim of domestic violence. Had it just been me, I probably would have not found him, if I'm being quite honest with you. So, go home with a smile, innit? So, can't complain, can you?
No crime.
Listen to me. Move.
He's armed with a weapon.
It's the police. Show yourself.
Police officer with taser.
Drop the knife. Drop it.
You're under arrest.
How do you feel about officially becoming a mentor?
You should not drive a vehicle without shoes.
He said that he's going to end his life.
And then he slashed his hand.
Show me your f***ing hands.
Police emergency.
Bring it down.
Stop, stop. Blue lights, what do they mean? Relax, brother.
Not what normal 22-year-olds see.
That's out here, boy. That's not very nice.
Wasn't expecting that.
I don't know if he's armed or anything.
Hey.
Friday night, I won't be anywhere else.
Hey.
Stroll out to November Echo for Echo.
Since I joined, I've always said I wanted to go on a blue light run. The Miami Vice theme tune. Clean clothes, Hawaiian shirts, driving Lamborghinis, chasing after people, great. So as soon as I passed, that was the first thing I did.
Jay, why on earth you put cheese on a sweet pancake with golden syrup?
Mr. Dyson, sometimes in life, you have to live life on the edge and mix it up.
I mean, you could be arrested for just having bad taste. I mean, it looks disgusting, it smells disgusting.
And it tastes great.
This is my final week on response. Unfortunately, I'm being moved to a different department.
Here we go, ambulance coming. Ready to wave.
The more grown-up detective three, job.
Two, one, one.
Hey!
Love it.
In the police, that is how it works. Where there's an operational need, they can move us wherever they want to move us, whenever they want to move us.
Okay, clear left.
I'm really, really going to miss the blue lights and my colleagues, even Andy Dyson.
Control to November Lima 4-3, Heather.
Yeah, Lima 4-3.
Caller to sustain, her ex-partner's got a metal pole and is smashing the upstairs of the house. She's been told to take the children and leave. Taser trained officers to be deployed, Heather.
Roger, thank you.
Domestic incidents are the most common job that we go to by a mile. They can really range from just a verbal argument to serious beatings. Knives have been used, blood everywhere.
Where to now?
Going right, at this roundabout. I've been to quite a few incidents that have been literally horror scenes.
Now,
so, where is he? Upstairs?
Yeah.
Cool, you just stay out here for me.
Has he still got the pole?
I don't actually know.
Okay.
You do feel a bit of anticipation because you've got possibly an aggressive suspect on scene with some sort of weapon.
It's the police, show yourself! Upstairs.
Okay.
If anyone is a threat to me, I don't really seem to get scared and nervous. I more just feel adrenaline and excitement.
Where are you, police officer with taser? Okay, open your hands up like that.
We had to be very, very cautious. Parties can get more aggressive, more hostile to the fact the police have arrived, and it can really go downhill. I was expecting a massive scrap, but he was calm as anything. I couldn't believe it.
Just keep your hands out for us.
OK. Under arrest on suspicion of criminal damage. Do not have to say anything, but it may arm your defence if you do not mention, when questioned, something which you later rely on in court. If you do say, maybe give an evidence, OK?
Mm-hmm.
Possibly the calmest suspect I've ever arrested for quite an aggressive offence.
Yeah, male detaining cuffs, no dramas. We keep the other unit coming, but not on a one, please.
Relationships and family life can be a definite incubator for violence.
Just go nice and slow for me, so I want you to trip, yeah?
You literally are witnessing the family break apart. And it can be quite sad, but you almost have to shut it off. You just got to get through it.
You're right.
Yeah.
Hello. Okay. There's some more officers that are going to come who are going to do all the sort of paperwork, the statements, things like that. Is that all right?
Yeah.
Cheers.
Yeah.
Right. We're off.
Let's do it.
Did you see what happened to the door?
Well, it absolutely pulverised them, didn't it?
Yeah.
He's certainly gone that with some enthusiasm.
Yeah. Wasn't much door left.
This is from the 1940s.
Okay.
Hefty girls wanted for police force. Women with brains plus good physique. Be at least 5'4". Oh my God, I'd never make it. They must be hefty enough to withstand a rough and tumble. And they must be fairly good looking. That's shocking.
Yeah? Cool. Sorted.
Check in the back. Yep, all good. Love that.
Can you go ahead?
Yeah, this female is on the floor. She's bleeding quite a lot.
Paramedics on scene?
Yes, yes, EMS are on scene.
November Echo 4-5, if you can make your way, please.
Roger, receive.
Me being in the police for a year now, I'm finally finding my feet. I have been kicked in the face. I've been punched once, twice, and sometimes someone's tried to grab me. Now I can definitely say that if anything is thrown my way, I will just take it head on.
Echo 4-5, UA.
Sorry, can I get you to leave? We need to move everyone out of the way.
As soon as we got there, it was just
people everywhere and there's so much going on, and we just need to help the ambulance service do what they needed to do.
There's no crime being called, so why are we here?
The reason is we're here to assist. We're here to assist, that's what we need to do. So obviously, we need everyone to kind of let EMAS do their job.
You're making it worse, lot.
Just listen to me.
The medical people are there, that's
yeah.
it. That's
the thing is, we're going to go back and forth if we carry on like this, okay?
We're going backwards and forwards and forwards and backwards.
I know, but obviously we need to move everyone out of the way.
Fuck off, mate. Are you stupid?
Listen to me. Listen to me.
We don't fucking
move away.
That is fucking assault.
Move.
That is assault.
There's no reason. Enough.
When someone is being aggressive, I can be quite vocal. And when I do, I'm like, oh my gosh, I sound like a mum telling someone off. Am I jumping in?
I believe.
Because my colleague's following after. Yeah. Is that okay? That incident, there was a lot going on, and at first I was like, is this going to be a bit overwhelming? But I managed to handle it as best as I could.
I've got shoes and a jacket and her bag with her phone, which she's been demanding for. So we'll be giving her stuff back and, yeah, heading back.
Ooh. People tend to forget that as police officers, you know, we are still humans. We're not all going to be just completely okay with things that we deal with, and sometimes it does take a toll on us. And that's not something I actually expected. On response, I think resilience is one of those big kind of key skills that you have to really have. I think over the year, I've certainly developed that as much as I could. And it's still a work in progress, you know, every day's a learning day.
Malcolm, how are you doing? You all right?
I'm good. How are you?
Yeah, not too bad.
It's good.
Good to see you again.
I know, it's been a while.
Yeah, how's it been? Busy day today?
Yeah, it's been really good. It's been very busy.
What sort of things have you been dealing with?
It's been a lot of dealing with just, like, normal vulnerabilities and stuff.
Yeah.
And then it's gone to another extreme, to, like, sudden deaths as well.
Oh, so, my God. And are there any areas that you're struggling with anywhere where you think I might need a bit of help and support?
Probably about 6 weeks in. Yeah. I did struggle because it was completely out of my comfort zone.
Yeah, I mean, I remember the first time that we met, yeah. You were really shy.
Yes.
You were really quiet.
Mm-hmm. I remember when I started, on my first day, I literally barely spoke to anyone. And then now, like a year later, I don't think I can stop talking. I could sit with someone all day and be like, yeah, we can talk about everything, that's fine. Even if it's got nothing to do with anything, it's fine, we can talk about it.
You know, within the course of the last year, what I've observed is you've become far more confident in your role. And I've just seen this journey from there to where we are now. And I'm really proud of you. I really, really am. I'm sure your family are also really proud of you.
Absolutely.
A lot of the young females look at people like yourself and think, wow, if she can do it, I can do it and I want to do it.
Yeah.
So how do you feel about officially becoming a mentor for those going through the process? I think it'll be really positive.
I'd love to do that. That'd be so good.
Yeah?
Yes.
We'll do it.
Absolutely.
I'd love to have you on board.
Oh my God, I'm so excited. Sounds like a plan.
I'm a city lad, 100%.
Imagine me farming. A few sheep, a few cows, a few horses. I think I'll probably lose them if I'm being honest.
Prior to Market Harborough, I was based in East Leicester.
I went from a very busy area, violent crime, robberies, stabbings, to a very rural area where you don't get your knife crime that often at all.
Control to Sergeant Ahmed.
Sergeant Ahmed.
Grade one, it's a female carrying knife. Last seen walking towards the playing fields, over.
That's received.
Hiya.
So you know where the goalposts are?
Yeah.
She's got, not far past them, she's been fumbling around in that grass.
What was she doing? Was she doing anything with it? Or
just... She just had it down by her side.
That's fine. Not to worry. We're going to have a look.
Yeah.
Hopefully she's dumped it.
Doesn't matter where you live, which area you're from, as far as I'm concerned. We've got a zero tolerance to knife crime. I've seen young kids who have passed away because they've been stabbed with a knife.
Hiya. Have you got a knife on you?
Yes.
Okay. Give me your hands. Don't put your hands anywhere, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah. Drop the knife. Drop it. Sergeant Ahmed, I've got the female. She's dropped the knife. You're under arrest, okay, for possession of a knife in a public place. You do not have to say anything, but it may harm your defence if you do not mention one question of which you later are in court. Anything you do say may be given in evidence, all right? Right. Come on, we'll walk back.
Oh, my God. So, I just went to cut flowers with the knife.
Yeah.
If you've got a knife in a public place, ultimately, I'll always make that decision to arrest.
You'll go to the station.
What?
And then in interview, you can give your account.
It's about trying to maximise safety for everybody.
That knife, it's not the biggest I've seen, but nevertheless, that knife will do definitely 100% damage. Worst case scenario, she gets taken to court for it. Her best case scenario is no further action is taken against her. But when you see the effects and the impacts of knife crime, you sometimes have to take that hard line.
Everyone, when was the last time you had a takeaway?
A long time ago.
Like, how long's that?
Like, at least 2 months.
Ooh.
Why? How often do you have a takeaway?
Night shift.
Ooh, that's criminal. Say, I'm just hungry. What's good from here, Jamie?
Steak and cheese wrap.
Steak and cheese wrap?
Meal, cheese and chips.
Okay, I'll get that then.
Before I was a police officer, I was living in Wales. Very, very quiet, small village. Lots of fields, definitely. Lots of sheep, lots of farms.
Can I not have onions on it, please? Yeah, thank you.
And I think I jumped straight from 0 to 100 when I came to Leicester.
Legend, thank you very much, mate. Have a good one.
A really hustle-bustle city.
Control out to November Echo 4 Echo.
Echo 4 Echo.
Can you assist with a job we've just had come through? We've got a suicidal male. See if we can see him at all.
Yes, yes, thank you.
He said that he's going to end his life by going to the park and hang himself after taking cocaine. And it says staying at Mum's. But we don't know where he is at the moment.
Suicidal people, especially if you don't know where they are, it does make you worry. You know, am I going to get to them in time? The worst case scenario is this could go very, very wrong.
Hello.
I'm his mother. Is drunk. Is in such a bad way.
Okay.
The role of a police officer is a very intrusive role. You see people in the worst times of their life. Yes, you've got to ask some very personal questions, but we have a job to do.
Echo 4 Echo. Just a quick update. I think what we'll do, we'll stick around here and hopefully he will return back. Is there anything that sort of caused his...
It's just the state he's in. Like you say, last night he'd been drinking and then he slashed his hand.
Oh, right, okay.
Something in the kitchen. I was trying to stop the bleeding. And you can't reason with him.
And it's difficult for you as well, isn't it?
It's very difficult for me. It is hard.
Yeah.
When you're new, it's scary a lot of the times, and your adrenaline is literally always going.
Go on, try and get some fats in.
Yeah.
You can have all the training in the world, but you can literally almost feel like you want the ground to swallow you whole because you think, what am I going to do?
Are you all right?
Listen. Talk to me.
Right, so basically... I've had problems all my life, but I'm on drink, I'm on drugs, and...
Yeah.
It's like I feel like I'm going out of my mind, and like, I don't know what to do, mate. I just... Man, if my mum here now, I'll be on the streets.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I've literally got nothing, mate. I've got no money, nothing.
Okay.
Last night... My mum reckons I tried to cut my bloody hand off, but it wasn't... To be honest, I was reaching for a knife when I, like...
Yeah. You were blind drunk.
I'm not going to kill myself, but... I have thought about it.
But you know, the fact that you're recognising that,
yeah, I do,
is a good thing,
yeah,
because you're not in denial of any of it.
I feel like a scumbag, don't get me wrong, but you know, when you're addicted to things, it's hard. It's really, you know what I mean?
I'm going to ask you a very important question. Do you want to come off the cocaine?
Yeah, I do.
You do? You want to come off the alcohol?
I do, mate.
Yes. Yeah.
When you've got someone who's opening up to you on quite a personal level, it's frustrating because you really want to help someone and you can see they want to help themselves, but obviously it's difficult for them.
You seem like a really nice chap.
Thanks.
And I want to help you, yeah? So I'm going to do a safeguarding referral and it'll go to all the relevant agencies that can help you, but ultimately you need to help yourself. That's your last one, all right?
It's my last one. Yeah,
it is. Good lad. If you want me to, I can ring you next week.
Yeah, please, yeah, mate. Yeah,
just
please.
See how you're getting
on.
Jamie.
Jamie.
Arifa.
God, how old are you guys?
Early 20s.
Early
20s. Please don't end up like this, but I feel you'll give me great advice. God, give us a COVID. Okay. Thanks, mate.
All right. Lovely. All right.
Look after yourself.
All right, I'll see you later then, both. No problem. All right, bye, Lane. Bye, both.
I would say things do upset me in the job. You know, there's some shifts where you can go home and you can get a bit sad. But you try and think, OK, well, I did everything I possibly could. Yes, it's OK to be upset, but then you go on to your next job.
Right, who's driving tonight?
Well, I always drive.
No, not tonight, mate.
Senior PC.
Mr. Dyson.
Pursuit trained.
Very last shift, therefore...
What are you doing with me bag?
I'm putting it somewhere. There you are. Give us the keys, then. Come on. Hand them over.
This is my final shift after 2 years on response.
Come on, then.
And Mr. Dyson is letting me drive.
He's got the hump because he's not driving. Permission to fire her up, Mr. Dyson.
Permission granted.
Thank you.
You know I'm a nervous passenger.
I do, yeah. It feels absolutely bizarre to have you in the passenger seat. Absolutely, I've never seen it in all. It
feels bizarre to
years.
Be in the passenger seat. Slow down, slow down, slow down, slow down.
It's like being on a driving test.
Have you enjoyed your time on response, then?
I've loved it. You know how much I've loved it. And I'll be very sad to go.
As Arnie Schwarzenegger said, I'll be back.
I'll be back.
So you'll be back.
Even with just 2 years' experience, I do feel like I know what I'm doing. I feel confident in it now. And I've already developed a cop spider sense.
Lima 44.
Out of it.
Could I have a moving vehicle check, please? Insurance, PNC and Niche.
Yes, please.
When we spotted that car, there was just something sticking out about it, and it indicated the wrong way a couple of times, and it was driving a slightly slower. Those things just click in your head to say, that car isn't right.
Right. Are you going to have words with him?
Yeah.
I'll check him out on here.
Hello.
You all right, mate?
How you doing?
Yeah, not bad.
You a bit lost?
Yeah, we're actually lost.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
Where have you been tonight? You been out, or...?
No, not been out, mate. I'm just doing a little driving lesson.
Oh, fair enough. The driver was a young female with a slightly older male. You can almost sense that the driver is nervous. It's 3 a.m. Right, this is a bit odd. Something's not correct here.
Have you got your licence on you?
I'm not currently got it on me.
No, it's okay. We'll just do our checks. So just give us 2 seconds.
Right, do you mind just switch the engine off, please? You should not drive a vehicle without shoes. This is the moment. I'm going to caution you.
You should be arrested.
No, not being arrested.
Just cautioned.
I'm more concerned about who's insured to drive it.
Oh, because I'm not insured on it.
You're not, are you?
Oh,
that's
what?
The problem.
Even if I'm fully comp?
Yeah, fully comp doesn't mean you can allow somebody else to drive your vehicle.
Fuck.
Right, I need to speak to you, all right? Just sit in the back of the car, please, Foy. I just need to ensure that
You are who you say you are.
I've got like my uni days and stuff. I don't know if that's any help.
Yeah, that'll fine.
Or my Apple ID and stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Jake? Yes, mate?
Is the driver sober?
I don't know, he just seemed a bit lively.
Well, I could seize the car. I don't particularly want to do that. If he can drive it.
Yeah.
I mean, that would be...
Let's do a check then. You're insured to drive that. So instead of us seizing that, let's just let you drive it away. The only thing I do need to ask is, would you be happy just to do a breathalyzer for us? Purely to make sure that you're all good to drive this in a sec. Blow, 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 stop. Lovely. Big fat zero. Thank you very much for your patience. All in order.
All right.
This is definitely the first time she's dealt with the police.
Is it? Yeah. Not ideal.
I'm surprised she's not crying. Good cop, bad cop.
That's it. But no, usually we'd be seizing the vehicle, but
really,
we don't think it's proportionate. I mean, we've got you here that could drive it.
And
just no need to get it locked up and impounded. I think
we're less than learnt enough
by giving a ticket. So. Yeah,
thank you very much.
No, you're welcome. We appreciate when people are polite and understanding of us, because we're just doing our job at the end of the day.
Right, that's fine. You'll hear from us in due course. I'm not going to take any action regards to the fact that you haven't been displaying any L plates. When you are driving, you need to wear L plates. You also need to wear shoes. Okay? In all likelihood, you'd be issued with 6 penalty points, which will sadly mean that you're off the road. I'm afraid, but...
Is there anything I can do?
I'm afraid not. You know, we've caught you driving with no insurance. If you hit another vehicle or injured anybody else, then, you know, the repercussions could have been much more serious. Okay, you're free to go now.
Thank you.
Take care. It's tough leaving response day to day. You just never know what you're going to encounter. Break-ins, stabbings, drunk guy in a taxi. You get to talk to people, you get to be friendly with people, and you can really make a difference. And I'm going to miss that element of being a police officer.
My definition of what a community is basically it's an area where you feel at home, where you feel at ease. It's a somewhere where you can basically simply just go back there and just truly be who you are.
So we're going back to St. Matthews on the East Leicester. St. Matthews was my old beat. I've got some kit with me for the kids. We're going to open up the van. They love it, I enjoy it, and hopefully, you never know, we might inspire one of them in 10 years' time to become a cop. If I could recruit everybody, I would.
For those of you who don't know, my name's Adam Ahmed. As you can tell, I'm a police officer. So here in Leicestershire Police, before I joined, there was no other Somali police officer. So I was pretty much the first one in, which was kind of cool.
I kind of felt the privilege being one of the first, being able to actually go in the organisation and represent. From the Somali community here in Leicester, everybody was chuffed, everybody was happy, because they were like, oh, it's fantastic to see one of ours actually going into the organisation.
At the moment, I work on response, but if I can try and get back to community policing, I will, actually. If the spot opens up and I can, you know, sneak back in.
The pizza's here.
Oh, is it? That's fine. Oh. Let's go and get some food then.
One of the best things that I enjoyed doing about this job is basically speaking to young people and engaging with the young people and, you know, trying to change those perceptions of the police.
Oh, sorry, bro, you're right. Hey?
First of all, they say, you're Somali. So you start talking to them in Somali. It's like they just, their face just like, oh, wow, okay.
Okay, cool. So this is the cage. Yeah? So, if, yeah, go on then. So, not all of you, not all of you, two at a time.
They get really excited and start jumping in the car, putting the blue lights on and everything.
Stick out in there. That suits you, innit? Yeah, it suits you.
Yeah, I do think the perception is changing and people are starting to see it as a viable career and a viable path.
He went to the same school as you did and he wants to be a police officer.
Okay, mashallah, that's very good, bro.
And you do see young people say, well, actually, if he's doing it, why can't I? And which is great.
The van, as always, was a hit. The Somali community here, we're not that big. We're a very small community compared to other areas in the country. I'm passionate, I'm determined to make this area nice. I get that professional challenges as well. And they give free food out like that. I'm happy to come down and help them.
Here it is, the final return to base.
Back to Loughborough for the very last
time. Yeah, that's it. Last time in the gates in a marked vehicle. No!
It was a nice shift to end on because I did get to spend time with Mr. Dyson, but it didn't feel real. It felt very surreal to be done.
Well, Jake, you drove well today in the main.
And thank you.
Best of luck for the future. Hope that we'll be crewed again in the not too distant.
Yes, fingers crossed.
It is sad that I'm moving, but there are positives to it. There is going to be a big growth opportunity for me.
See you later.
Brand new department, Child Criminal Exploitation Department. Getting in touch with the young drug runners who are being exploited and trying to target the big boys.
It was weird taking it off. Very last time. There it is.
I think I'm just blindsided by Love and Response so much that I can't see myself doing anything better. But it's going to make me into a better, well-rounded cop, so absolutely got to see the bigger picture and go for it.
Done and dusted.